In 2009, mobile devices began outselling PCs. The same year saw the launch of the iPad, the fastest-selling consumer product of all time. Saylor says that half of the economy will be disrupted by the mobile wave over the next decade. It will impact the way you're entertained, the way you bank, and the way you get your health care, not to mention the profound impact this technology will have on education, corruption, and the developing world. But what does this mean exactly? For entertainment. Transformation here starts with the gradual disappearance of the traditional camera. It's being absorbed into mobile devices and has created a revolution in taking and sharing pictures. Mobile technology hasn't changed photography, it's changed how we relate to each other. A mind-boggling 2.5 billion photographs are uploaded to Facebook every month, and 76% of mobile owners use their devices to take pictures. If photos were at the forefront of this movement, video is not far behind. Consider that YouTube took just 6 months to build a content library equivalent to the entire output of the three main US TV networks from 1948 to 2008. For money and security, physical money is on the way out. It's costly to produce and safeguard and time-consuming to transact. The same goes for ID, like driver's licenses. Soon, they'll all be incorporated into our cell phones thanks to technology like QR codes and near-field communication, which enables digital signals to be read just by waving them in front of a reader. Of course, this will only work if systems are significantly more secure than they are today. No problem, says Saylor. Passwords are passé. Instead, mobile devices will be able to authenticate their owner. After all, a touch device should be able to read fingerprints. For good measure, the built-in camera can check your unique retina and iris forms, while voice recognition tunes into your vocal patterns. For healthcare, in Saylor's future world, patients can use their mobiles to consult doctors around the globe and even get them bidding on the cost of performing surgery. Mobile technology will also become an invaluable aid to the visually impaired. For example, GPS navigation systems and built-in digital compasses could enable mobile devices to issue spoken instructions like, Robinson's Hardware is 20 feet in front of you, or the picnic table is on your left. For education, in the past, children were hostages to the traditional system. For example, a child a generation ago had the opportunity to learn a second language in school at a cost of around $10,000 for 1/30th of a teacher. 5 years from now, a child with a $300 tablet will have the option of learning 100 languages and get all of the teacher for around 5 cents. Finally, the area that stands to gain the most from the mobile wave is the developing world. It's remarkable to think that 90% of the world's population now has potential access to mobile networks. That's more than has access to good drinking water. 2/3 of the world's 4.6 billion mobile phone owners live in emerging nations. The mobile wave is having impact in ways you wouldn't ever think of. It's actually washing away layers of corruption by eliminating middlemen who previously controlled access to information or resources. In Kenya, for example, mobile banking enables firms to deposit salaries directly into employee bank accounts, excluding supervisors who previously withheld pay packets until bribes were paid. The mobile wave is an unstoppable force moving at blinding speed. It's already revolutionizing the way we entertain ourselves, transact business, and protect our identity. It has transformed the way we communicate and interact with each other in ways we couldn't have imagined 10 years ago. And the best is yet to come for those who see the opportunities and seize them.